have to say, it's unbelievable to me. So I'm enormously grateful and so humble that the scholars and readers chose this book and that the National Book Foundation exists, especially in the times we live in which many people just don't read. First of all, I have to say thank you to Marie Brown, my literary agent, who I couldn't get a contract for the book on my own. And a friend of mine said, you know, you ought to call Marie. And I talked with her about it. And she said, you know, you're going to have to, like, write a book proposal for this, you know, not just your ideas. And she taught me how to promote and convince Oxford University Press, to do this book. Because as some of you may know who've looked at the book or have just lifted it up, right? It's a heavy book, but it's also about Oxford. And so I wanted this book to be at Oxford University Press. And finally, I was able to secure that. And in the 90s, it was very important for me. I was at a certain point, I'd gotten a chunk of it done, and I proposed it. And I heard from Susan Ferber, the best editor that anyone can have. And she said, you know, Jeffrey, at that time, I had half the book done. And she said, you know, we're not going to publish two books. But we will publish one large book. And I don't think she realized at that time what she was saying, because it ends up being a very large book, but one that I am enormously grateful for Oxford University Press to put in the time and the money to make this book what it is. And the whole staff there, Nico, particularly and Angela Messina and others, have promoted and supported me in this process. In the course of a book like this, taking many, many years to do, I incurred many debts. My great friend E. Kermie Price, who labored over the book with me and read it, and at one point said, am I the only person who believes this can be a great book? And at that time, I think he was. Okay. But others still, Julie Thatcher, who was a wonderful editor, helped me learn how to write creative nonfiction. My friend Hugo Hopping, who essentially introduced me to what it means to be an artist and what Locke's struggle with artistry was all about and working with artists. Just legions of other people, Clarence Walker and others. I just also want to say just a word of my family, Anissa Stewart, who without whom this book would not exist, and my son, Conrad Stewart, and Cassandra. And that leads me to think about Locke. And I just take just 1 minute. You know, if he was here right now accepting this award, he wouldn't have a family with him. As a gay man who lived a closeted life, he had many struggles, and one of them was with tremendous, crushing aloneness. And so when I stand here, I think about his achievement. And what that was to create a family among writers and artists and dancers and dramatists and call them the new Negro. The basis for a new creative future, not just for Black people, a new Negro for a new America. Thank you, Alan Locke.